August 6th, 2022. I'm your host, Colin Jason, hyphen Matthew Colin Glass. You may call me Jason. And this week we're going to be looking at the regular headlines from the past week, as well as we're going to have a meme of the week, and also the cognitive conjecture section. Followed by that, I'm going to be sharing with you a very special drink recipe. If you remember, a couple weeks ago, I asked if anybody wondered what it was I was drinking. At the time, the beverage of my choice. Well, in response to the Kooliana I received from that, I'm going to be sharing with you the recipe in video form. So stay tuned to that. Let's get on to the first headline. So this week, the jury finds Alex Jones caused $4 million in damages to two Sandy Hook parents. So as you can plainly see, we have quite a series of tangible contract adjectives culminating in a tangible contract pronoun followed by adverb in, modifying damages into a verb, future tense adverb to, tangible contract word T-W-O, which is the number, and then adjective Sandy, adjective hook, and then pronoun parents. $4 million in damages Alex Jones caused. Ladies and gentlemen, if this is not evidence of how rotten the system is, then I don't know what is. Next headline, drag queen story time in England promotes compassion and inclusion. British far-right extremists are importing U.S. hate against them. So to look at this from a fiction standpoint, drag queen story time, which I remember seeing a year or two ago, where they would have, I guess, male individuals dressed up as females telling children stories, some of them sexually explicit. I guess they brought that to England because it promotes compassion and inclusion, and as we know, IN means no, so it means no inclusion contract. So the British far right extremists are importing U.S. hate against them. So the British far right, you know, not the right that are here, but the ones that are way over there, the extreme rights, they are importing U.S. hate, or us hate. So they're importing hate. I wonder what the taxes are on that. Against them. Against who? Against British far-right extremists? Why would they import hate against themselves? Ladies and gentlemen, this is another goofy example of CNN's fictitious conveyance of grammar. We have adjective, adjective, pronoun, adverb, adjective, adjective, pronoun, conjunction, pronoun. So here's a cool scenario. We have the 3-4 scenario, and then we have the 1-3-4 scenario, and then we have the 4 and the 4 connected by the neutral condition of state conjunction and, because there are two conjunctions, and an or as a choice, and as a command. And in this case, it is a bridge between the two pronouns, British is adjective. Far right, you can't see it there maybe, but there is a hyphen connecting the far and the right, so therefore it's one compound adjective. And then extremist is adjective, R is adjective because R is tangible contract. Importing has the particle of negation IM and also particle of negation ING. Us, whether it's US or us. In this case, it's US because that is what they mean. They've capitalized it, even though it's even in fiction, even in under fiction rules, it's an improper abbreviation, but they mean US. Hate, which is a pronoun, and we know nothing can follow a pronoun except for breaking the continuance of the evidence, or in this case, an adverb against, and in them, which is dangling participle verb. Next headline. Good news for once. Parts of the Great Barrier Reef record highest amount of coral in 36 years. So parts of the Great Barrier Reef are recording things. Maybe they have some technology, they've been given a government grant for recording devices, but parts of the Great Barrier Reef have recorded highest amount of coral in 36 years, which is awesome. We have pronoun, adverb, adjective, 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 pronoun, which is one of the five syntax patterns, 4-1-3-4. And then we have another syntax pattern, the 1-2 of coral, and then a 1-3-4, which is another syntax pattern. Very interesting that 80% of the ocean is unexplored. It's unknown. 20% is known. Think about that, folks. 80% of the oceans on Earth are unknown. Next headline. This one comes from the go to alternative news site, sot.net. What is a woman? Adverb, verb, adverb, dangling participle, verb. And then they go on to fill it in and say definitions don't help. Keep in mind, ladies and gentlemen, definitions, DE means no, finite means a limit, and ION means contract. So no finite contract. It doesn't help. No shit. Pardon my language. And this makes gender ideology even more dangerous. Ooh. It's so dangerous. Is it dangerous just like murderers and rapists are dangerous? Is that the same type of danger, or are we talking about something else? Big news, the WNBA star Brittany Griner sentenced to 9 years in Russian jail for drug smuggling. Adjective, 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 pronoun in the past tense, adverb in the past tense, adjective, pronoun, adverb, adjective, pronoun, adverb, dangling participle, verb. You gotta wonder why people would even try to do anything like that. Again, the court system is, doesn't matter what country you're in, it's just completely rotten from the ground up. No doubt about it. Final headline of the day. Blinken says he hopes Beijing will not manufacture a crisis after Pelosi's visit to Taiwan. Again, the old apostrophes being utilized as quotations, literally, with the rules of boxing. This headline says Blinken says he hopes after Pelosi's visit to Taiwan. So Blinken has some hope, and that's awesome that he has hope. Blinken is an adjective, says is a pronoun, he is an adverb, hopes is a verb. Then we have a break and it continues the evidence because we have a space. Then we have the apostrophe slash quotations. And then we have another space. So that's two spaces. That's excessive spacing, breaking the continuum to the evidence. And then we start again with adverb after, adjective Pelosi, pronoun visit, adverb in the future tense to, and in Taiwan, dangling participle verb. That wraps up the headlines for the week. Let's move on to the meme of the week. I thought this was pretty funny. What do you think the syntax is for no one and Instagram models? Feel free to put your guesses in the comments fields. Let's move on to the next section, the cognitive conjecture. So this video comes from the colon space Russell hyphen J colon Gould channel, and it's a repost of this individual here. If you can see my highlight here, it says Ryan Day Ryan Team Light .com. Here's the thing though, whoever that is, Ryan D. Rion, I don't know if it's this individual's name or not, but it's all capped, so I'm sorry to say, condolences go out to that individual's family that they passed away because their name is in all caps. Or at least Russell G. Gould put their name in all caps, and so that must mean that they've passed away. As you can see here, ladies and gentlemen, as I've shown again and again and again and again, you have the colon space, colon space, colon space, colon space, which means of the, which is incorrect. Every correct sentence structure, whether it's a sentence with a verb or a title or a name, must start with a cause, for the, in order to maintain the mathematical interface on the grammar. This breaks the mathematical interface because it starts with of the. So this is not correct sentence structure. Here it is in all caps again. Ooh. And then they put that in brackets. Okay, anyways, let's get into this here.
You know, to make it relevant for everyone on Earth, there's some intel coming out that when they were messing with CERN and some weird things, you know, hence why we're recording this on StreamYard. And you know what I mean? Hey, we're going to talk about some real things right now. But there's a lot of holographic things and creating distortions. And what kind of came out was that between, I believe, the end of February, April, there were 6 months of data downloaded in 2 months. So everything was hyper accelerated. That's why.
What is he talking about? Where was the data downloaded?
Our dream time, our energy was off the chain. It's because literally timelines are going like this. And when they touch us and they sync, you're getting 6 months of data in 3 weeks this fast. So what happens is it speeds the whole equation up. You know, the issue with that is like, I'm like, you know, hashtag, can you sprinkle a little more golden light and some sprinkles on me? Like, I don't, how much?
That's a massive hashtag.
How much of this stuff do we got to, bro, how much of this stuff do we actually have to watch? You know what I mean? Like, what, you know, like, go ahead. And here's the thing, you're going to get us out. You've got the theory, you've got the equation. And I already kind of, they gave me the download this morning on like your real position. Like, I know you got like, I'm the postman. And I was like, wait a minute, like, who's my brother really? You know what I mean? Like the real you, you know what I mean? So go ahead. Tell me a little bit more, bro.
Hold on. Wow. That was a mouthful that individual just said. Sort of implying that, whatever titles that Russell here claims, that's not who he really is, that he's really something else. But maybe we don't know what that is. Let's find out. Let's see what Russell has to say about it.
I'm someone that is on the quest of being correct and learning about the perspective of correct.
So he just said he is on the quest of being correct and learning to be correct. So if I take that literally, that means he's not correct. He's on a quest of being correct or learning to be correct. He's not correct, but he's learning to be correct. Maybe I can rewind that.
I'm someone that is on the quest of being correct and learning about the perspective of correct.
Oh, learning about the perspective of being correct and on the quest of being correct. So that is correct. Russell just admitted, ladies and gentlemen, that he's on the quest of being correct and learning about the perspective of being correct. I.e., Russell is not correct. He just said it. Not my words, his words. He's on a quest of being correct. He wants to learn the perspective of being correct. Well, here's the good news, Russell, and whoever else is watching this. If you want to learn about being correct, if you want to learn correct sentence structure, communication, parse, syntax, grammar, feel free to email me at the email listed at the bottom of your screen here. You send me an email and I will set up a 10 to 15 minute video consultation where we'll see if you truly are on a quest of being correct, because you can apply for a correct sentence structure, communication, parse, syntax, grammar workshop from me, and I will teach you this grammar and I will give you closure on it, you know, as far as you're motivated to go with it on your quest of being correct. I appreciate your candor there. And there you have it for your cognitive conjecture. And also some quite stunning closures that Russell is on the quest of being correct. He's not there yet. He's not quite there yet. And he doesn't really have closure on the perspective of being correct because he's not correct. He just said it. Ladies and gentlemen, this is not me saying this. It's him. I'm using his words, and you just heard him say it two times. So, my offer stands, big guy. All right, let's move on to the next portion of the program where I'm going to share with you the recipe for the drink of the evening. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you enjoyed this week's edition of For the Now Space News. Hope you enjoyed the little drink recipe that I shared with you. And, you know, if I'm to give you full closure on the reason why I included that in there, I'm a big fan of the King of Cool, Dean Martin, the Rat Pack, Frank Sinatra, Sammy Davis Jr., Dean Martin, so on and so forth, and the way things were done back in the 50s and 60s and even some of the 70s. It was just a different time, a different now space, and I try and bring a little of that to this, you know. So that's the whole volition behind that, and also to teach a little bit of syntax knowledge. Of course, if you want to learn about correct sentence structure, communication, parsing, syntax, grammar, and you're serious about it, there are over 400 videos on this very YouTube channel. People ask me, where do we start? You can start here. Start wherever. Check out the playlists. Check out the chronology of the videos. Part 0, Part 1, Part 2, Part 3. Jump in wherever. I've invested thousands of hours in creating these videos to give them to you. It's my gift. It's contingent upon you to invest your now space in studying them and honoring my efforts. If, however, you want to fast track your learning and you want me as a guide, you can email me at this email address right here and apply for a correct sentence structure, communication, parsing, syntax, grammar workshop. I will schedule you a 10 to 15 minute consultation, video consultation. I'll provide the location and any questions you have will be answered during that consultation. It's up to you to take that first step though. Appreciate you being here. Thanks for watching. See you next week. Salut.